equations and solving the problems. It's all about understanding. Is it? Yes. To understand the lesson clearly, we have to read the theory part of the lesson. It makes us to understand the mathematics in a better way. In this class, we are going to learn about the third lesson, playing with numbers. Yes. Before going to playing with the numbers, we are going to play with the balls. Yes. Here, I have taken the 8 balls, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, I want to arrange these balls in a row in such a way that each row has an equal number of balls. Okay, so here I arrange here in the first picture. In each row there is a one ball. In each row there is a one ball. I will write as 1 into. Then how many rows are there here? Let's count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. There are 8 rows, which is equals to 8, is it? Then similarly, second one, each row has 2 balls. Then how many rows are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Each row has 2 balls. There are 4 rows. So I can write it as 2 into 4, which is equals to 8. Similarly, the third arrangement, so each row has 4 balls, each row has 4 balls, then how many rows are there here? Yes, here there are 2 rows, which is equals to 8 balls, is it? Then finally, the last one is, each row has 8 balls, then number of row is only 1, which is equals to 8. Yes. Is there any possible to arrange in different pattern? No, it is not possible. Yes. From these calculations, we can observe that 2 and 4. Yes. 2 into 4 is equals to 8. So 2 and 4 are exactly divide the 8. See here, there is an 8. Then 2. 2 how much are 8? That is 2, 4 are 8, which is equals to 0. The remainder is 0 means 2 is exactly divides the 8. Similarly, 4 is also exactly divides the 8. So we can say that 2 and 4 are the exact divisors of 8. 2 and 4 are exact divisors. Exact divisors of 8. Similarly, you can observe here 8 into 1, which is equals to 8. Here 8 and 1 are exactly divides the 8. Is here 8 is 8 1 jump 8, it is also divides 1 8 jump 8, it is also exactly divides the 8. So we can call it as 8 and 1 are exact divisors of 8. Can you say that? Yes, 8 and 1 are exact divisors of 8. We can say that 1 is also exactly divides the 8, and 2 also exactly divides the 8, and 4 also exactly divides the 8, and at last 8. So these are the exact divisors of 8. So these are called as factors of 8. Factors of 8. So these are called as factors of 8. Okay? Yes. Let's see the definition of factors. Factors means a factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. A factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Yes, let's check. So, which number exactly divides the 9? Yes. I will take the example 9. Let's check. So, I will start from the 1 and this 1 how much are 9? That is 1 9 jump 9. Then the remainder is 0. Then next, second, 2. Let's check 2 is exactly divides the 9 or not. Yes, 2 fours the 8. 9 minus 8 is 1. So it doesn't exactly divide. Then next number 3. 3 ja 9. Subtract here 9 minus 9 is 0. 3 is exactly divides the number. Then next 4. 4 2's are 8. Subtract 9 minus 8 is 1. So it also doesn't divide the number exactly. Then next number 5. 5 1's are 5. The remainder is 4. 5 is also doesn't divide the 9 exactly. Then 6. 6 1's are 6 minus 3. So 6 also doesn't divide the 9 exactly. Then 7. 1's are 7. Then the remainder is 2. So it also doesn't divide the 9 exactly. Then 8. 8 1's are 8. Remainder is 1. So it also doesn't divide the 9 exactly. At last 9. 9 1's are 9. Remainder is 0. See here, 1 divides the 9 exactly. Means 1 is the exact divisor of 9. And here 2 doesn't divide the 9. And 3. 3 is also exactly divides the 9 because the remainder is here 0. Then 4, it doesn't divide the 9 because the remainder is 1. Then 5 also doesn't divide. 6 also it doesn't divide. 7 also doesn't divide. 8 also it doesn't divide. Then 9. So 9 is an exact divisor of 9. Why? Because the remainder is 0. Yes, hence we can say that. So the exact divisors of 9 are 1, 3 and 9. The exact divisors of 9 are 1, 3 and 9 are the factors of 9. Yes, the definition says that a factor of same number is an exact divisor of that number. The exact divisors of 9 are 1, 3 and 9. So these are the exact divisors. So they can call it as factors of 9. Okay? Yes, here I have taken an example. Find the factors of 36. Means we have to find the exact divisors of 36. Yes, from yes, in the solution. So 1 into 36. 136 is the 36. Okay, then next 2, how much are 36? 2, 18 is 36. Then 12, 3 is 36 or 3, 12 is 36. Then 4, 9 is 36. In 5 tables, 36 will not come. In 6 tables, it comes. 6, 6 is 36. Okay, yes. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. So these are the exact divisors of 36. And also 36 also exactly divides the 36. And 18 also divides the 36 exactly. Then 12 divides the 36 exactly. Then 9 also is an exactly divisor of 36. And 6, 6 is 36. So it is also exactly divides the 36. So we can say that 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 9. next 9, 12, 18, 36 are the exact divisors of exact divisors of 36, and we can also call it as, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18, 36 are factors of Okay. In this way, you can also find out the factors of given numbers. Yes. Then the next concept is multiples. Yes. For example, I will take here one of the boards of length 5 cm. Yes. The length of the box is 5 cm. Okay. Length of one box is 5 cm. Similarly, I will take the other one box. I will join through this box. Yes. What is the total length of these two boxes? Yes, that is 10. If I add again 5 cm box, then the total length is 10. Okay? Similarly, I add another one box to these two boxes. Yes. What will be the total length? Yes, that is 50. Continuing this way, we can express the other lengths like 20, 25, next 30, like this. So here 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 are the multiples of 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 are the multiples of 5. We can observe here, multiples of the number is equal to the number or greater than the number. Yes, similarly you can write the multiples of 6. Yes, multiples of 6 are 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, etc. So we can write an infinite number of multiples of the given number. So here, observe here, 6 is a given number. The multiple of 6 is equal to the number or greater than the numbers. Okay? Yes. Let's conclude about the factors of multiples. Yes, let's we can conclude the factors of multiples. We can also say that characteristics of factors of multiples. Yes, first see the factors. Yes. One is the factor of every number. Yes, here I have written factors of some numbers. You can observe here, in every number, one is an exact divisor. Means one is a factor of every number. Is it? Second one, every number is a factor of itself. Every number is a factor of itself. See here, 8. The given number is 8 here, so it is a factor of itself. Means it is also 8 is a factor of the number itself. Here the number is 9. The factor of 9 is also 9. Means the factor of 9 is the number itself. Then similarly 10, and 10 is also a factor of the number itself. Then 12. 12 is a factor of the number itself. Then the third one is, every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Every factor of a number is an exact divisor of the number. As you can see here, the factor definition only says that the exact divisor of a number is a factor of the number. Is here 9. So 3 is exactly divides the 9, and 9 is also exactly divides the 9. Similarly, 1 is exactly divides the 11, and 11 is also exactly divides the 11. And you can see 6 is exactly divides the 12, and 4 is also exactly divides the 12. Yes, every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Okay, then fourth one, every factor is less than or equal to the given number. As you can observe here, every factor of a number is less than the given number. Observe here, 1, 2, 4 are less. factor is also 8, means it is equal. 8 is equal to 8. Then similarly 11, factors of 11 is 1, so 1 is smaller than the 11 and 11 is also equal to 11. Okay, then 12. So observe here, factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. So here up to the 6, so there are lesser than the given number, means smaller than the given number, and also 12 is equal to the given number. Okay, then last one, the number of factors of given number is finite. The number of factors of given number is finite, means there are limited number of factors. Yes, here you can see that 8 has 4 factors, 9 has 3 factors, 10 has 4, and 11 has 2, 12 has 6 factors. So except these, we cannot find out the exact differences of the given number. So these are limited. So these numbers only exactly divide the given number. So we can say that the number of factors of a given number is finite, means these are limited number of factors. Then let's see the facts of the multiples, or properties of multiples, or characteristics of multiples. Yes, the first one is every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to that number. Every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to that number. See here, I have written some of the examples of the multiples. Yes, so 4 is a multiple of 4. 4 is a multiple of 4, means it is equal to the given number, and also it is greater than the given number. So multiples are equal to the given number or greater than the numbers. Then second one, the number of a multiples of a given number is infinite. Yes, here the given numbers are 4, 5, 6. So I have the only the 4 multiples, but we can write up to n number of multiples of a given number. So we can say that multiples are infinite numbers. So then third one, every number is a multiple of itself. Yes, every number is a multiple of itself. Then 4 is a multiple of itself, then 5 is a multiple of itself, and 6 is a multiple of itself. So here I have given conclude about the factors and multiples. Yes, then the next concept is perfect numbers. What is mean by perfect number? A number for which sum of all its factors is equal to twice the number is called perfect number. Once again, a number for which sum of all its factors is equal to twice the number is called perfect number. Yes, let's see one of the example, that is 6. Yes, write the factors of 6 here. So factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3, then 6. Then sum of all the factors, sum means we have to add, sum of the factors is twice the number. Yes, let's see, is it twice the number or not? Yes, add here 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11, 11 plus 1, 12. Yes, the sum of the factors of 6 is 12. So we can write it as 12. So 2 into 6. Here 2 means twice. Twice the given number. So 6 is a perfect number. Yes, once again. So we have written the factors of 6 and we added the sum of the factors, we get that twice of the number. So the 6 is a perfect number. Similarly, we can check for the other number. Is it perfect number or not? Yes, let's see here. Yes, let's take other one example. 28, which is equals to, yes, factors of 28 are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, then 28. Is it? Then add here, sum of the factors of the given number is, first I will add 28 plus 2, 30, then 30 plus 14, 44, 44 plus 1, 45, 45 plus 4, 49, 49 plus 7, 56. The twice of the 28 is 56. Is it? So we can say that 28 is a perfect number. Is let's check for the 10. The factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. If some of the factors is 10 plus 5, 15, 15 plus 2, 17, 17 plus 1, 8. Yes, the sum of the factors is 18. So 10 is not a perfect number because twice of the 10 is 20. So it is not equal to the 20. So it is not a perfect number. Similarly, you can find out the numbers, are they perfect numbers or not. Okay, in the next class we are going to solve the exercise 3.1. Thank you.